do we win the Champions League without sort of changing our way of playing, changing our style? And he didn't. It was just little tweaks. It was just maybe I played in the midfield a little bit more, or Bex did, and I stayed out wide. But also he brought in Yapstam because, especially at Old Trafford, he still wanted us to attack. He still wanted the fullbacks to overlap. He still wanted midfielders getting into the box. But also he had two defenders, Ronny Jansen and Yapstam. They were quick, they were strong, and they could defend one-on-one. I think the manager recognised that Yap was the, just like Eric, was that sort of final piece of the jigsaw. A lot is talked about the four forwards that we had. But also in my position, Jesper Blomqvist. In midfield, you had Nicky Butt, who obviously played in the Champions League final. We had so many players who could play all the games, but also we had players who could come in who give you that freshness, but you didn't lose the quality. Every team wanted to beat you at that time. So it was a juggling act for the manager of getting that freshness, but also having that quality on the pitch that can win you the game. The manager, I remember before getting me and Bex in and saying, I don't know who I'm going to play centre midfield, because if I played centre midfield along with Nicky, then that would give us the balance still of Bex and Jesper on the left. Or Bex gives us that little bit more control, rather than a different player in midfield like myself, who would be more of a dribbler. And then I would play on the right, which, especially with when Sharpie and Andre were in the team, so Sharpie would play on the left, I would play on the right. But it wasn't sort of my favoured position. But he went with Bex, a little bit more control in midfield, and me on the right, which I could play. So it was a difficult decision for him, I think. I didn't have the best of games, but I think later on in the game, the running that I'd done against the left back, I think it was Tarnat, contributed in later on, giving us that space and that pinning them back later in the game. So yeah, I say we had the strength in depth. That was a blow, obviously, not having Keenan Scholes, but we were still able to manage with players who had played in the lead up. Yes, we played in the FA Cup semi-final. He started that game. Obviously, Nicky had played enough games as well. So yeah, we were able to cope in the end. My first season where I really played in midfield, Chicharito had just come in and said, okay, Chicha, where do you want the ball? I get the ball in midfield. Where's your runs? Are you peeling off over the left centre half? Are you running in behind the right centre half? So instantly, when I get the ball, I know more or less where he's going to be. Wayne dropping in them little holes. G. Sampat, where do you want the ball? Okay, he's coming in the pitch. Patrice Evra's then overlapping. So I have a choice. G's in that little pocket. If the fullback comes, I play it over the top to Patrice, who's going to be overlapping or sometimes underlapping. Where's Cristiano going to be? Is he going to be high and wide, or is he going to be making them run? So before I even step on the pitch, I had in my locker where I was going to hurt the opposition the most. It become more, as you get older, more like chess, like trying to find the right moves. And it is a bit like the Matrix as well, that everything just slows down a little bit. Whereas when you're younger, it's just 100 miles an hour. So yeah, you definitely take a lot more interest in the tactical roles. Okay, how are the opposition pressing? How do you want to press? All these things that you would never think about as a young player. Who's the danger man in their team? Is he left-footed? Is he right-footed? Keep him on his right. Okay, are you going to play against a midfielder who's constantly be running in behind you? Okay, right. See if they want to run him. They want to keep running because you're going to run them. So I wasn't able to get up and down the pitch as much, but rather than blowing up after 60 minutes, you have to pace yourself. And I was equally as effective, but probably wasn't doing as much running. So yeah, for me, and it, like anything, experience as well. That experience that the game sort of slows down in your mind, where you know you can see passes and you're a lot calmer on the ball. I kept the ball a little bit better, not trying to that Hollywood pass every time, you know, just keep it ticking and then play them balls behind the opposition's defence or play them balls through the lines into the centre forward's feet. We had a optician or eye specialist at the club, and she actually noticed something, that when I did come into midfield, I wasn't playing as many passes left as I was right. So we did a lot of work on my peripheral vision, and it found that I didn't have as good eyesight looking that way, which is, yeah, when you think about it, it's natural. For since I was 11, I'd always looked that way because I'd been hugging the touchline, so I'd always had that pass, where actually she'd noticed there was a few runs that players were making that I hadn't noticed as well as there. So I did a lot of work on my eyesight that way, trying to strengthen that vision, looking that way, because now I'm looking at the whole pitch. I'm getting the ball in the middle of the pitch. There's players running there, there's players running there. So I did a lot of work on that. When you've got the energy that I had around me, Wayne Rooney dropping in, Ji-Sung Park on the left, Patrice Evra up and down, Michael Carrick next to me, I had energy and young legs all around me. So I was lucky in that respect as well. And I had to develop my passing because I was always able to dribble, which again, in midfield was great for me because maybe I had Paul Gascoigne who would get the ball in midfield and take players on. That was something that I had in my armour as well. If it wasn't on to pass, I could dribble past players, which the opposition midfielder perhaps wasn't used to. So I loved it. I loved being more involved. I loved having them different options. The last probably 5 or 6 years were the most enjoyable. As you get older, then you start thinking, okay, you've been told to do that, why? I was always asking, especially the last 6 or 7 years, the advice of Mick Phelan, Rennie Mullenstein, the coaches, Carlos Queiroz, you know, why are we doing that? And also saying, you know, giving them options, you know, what about this? So, yeah, you start definitely thinking more of a coach and you become more vocal in the dressing room as well. You know, even at halftime, giving your opinion a lot more, helping the younger players, both in training and after games. Your role in the team becomes different from when you were younger, when you're just really looking after yourself. You know, you're putting so much pressure on yourself and you're worried about your performances rather than the whole team's performance. Well, I didn't know what was obviously going to happen with David Moyes coming in. I think I had a year left on my playing contract and I was actually on my pro license. I was in Turkey, we were watching the under 20s World Cup and I got the phone call off David Moyes asking me to be part of his coaching staff and remain as a player. So I had a decision to make. Could I do both? Could I do the coaching and the playing? I was thrilled to be asked to be on the coaching because that's the next step. I just said I was already on my pro license, so I'd done my B license. I was nearly completing my pro license, so I was ready in regards to all my qualifications, but actually getting on the training pitch and putting coaching sessions on, I'd never really done. So I was keen to have that development, but also have an impact on the pitch. So it was a difficult decision to make. I think it was a team that their key players coming towards the end of their careers, obviously myself, Rio, you had Nemanja Vidic, all sort of coming towards the end, depending on the individual, how old they were. So it was difficult in that respect. And also putting your own stamp on a team, every coach wants to do that. So it was easy in regards to you're coming into a team that's just won the league, so it must be a good team, but also a team that did need a little bit of freshness as well. It was pretty easy because I don't think there was an alternative for a start. it was easy because it was only 4 games. I had good people around me joining the coaching staff, you know, Scalzi, Nicky, Phil, who'd have been a coach that season. The difficult part was I was still a player and, you know, I'm not picking some of my mates, some of my teammates who have shared a dressing room for a long time. So that was the difficult part. And also I knew that it was going to be my last year as well. So I wanted to enjoy it as a player as well, which I probably never got the chance in the end, but I got the chance to manage Manchester United, didn't it? I talk about the badges and the qualifications, you need them and it's great, but nothing prepares you for the actual experience of being in that hot seat, being in the office after training, picking a team, the problems that you encounter, you know, organising travel, organising different times, players knocking on your door because they're young players knocking on your door, they're coming to the end of their contract, what's happening? And also everything on the pitch, preparing a team for training, picking a team. So it was brilliant. It was an unbelievable experience. I put myself under a lot of pressure to win the four games. It was an experience that I would never change. And it was in that time, I think especially after we got beat at Sunderland here 1-0, that I knew that I had the mentality and the right stuff to become a manager, because I talk about teammates and friends. After that defeat, I had no problem in not picking them. And I didn't lose any sleep over it because they didn't perform. So then I sort of had that. I knew I had it in me to sort of make the tough decisions.
Thank you.